know, we're innovating in a regulated industry. So we almost had to stair step our business plan, and it started as content, then tools, and then advice. We couldn't turn on the advice because we didn't have the venture capital behind us to be able to go have a chief compliance officer, have all the security and technology we needed in place. And so I remember almost just putting one foot in front of the other. And I said to myself, this is going to be a 10-year plan. And I really emotionally signed up to go run a company for a decade. And I think in retrospect, you know, it's easier to go, people now like myself have kind of pioneered innovating in regulated industries. If you think about it, Uber innovated in a regulated industry. Lots of people in biotech had done it before, but in the fintech world, there wasn't like a clear path to do that. And, you know, I wasn't in a position to say I'd like to raise $25 million to get in business and go do this properly, being, you know, a young first-time entrepreneur. So the path there was a lot of, I almost like thought of it as like lassoing, like we'd hit a hurdle and make it, and then I could get to the next summit because we'd proven that we could execute in a really profound way. And so by the time we got acquired, we were calling about 200 employees, just under. We had 75 to 80 financial planners in our call center in Arizona. We had an engineering team of about 50 people, and we were really starting to hit an inflection point of supreme growth.